previously on Toss of Friends when Broadway Adventures.
Hello, Percy. Finishing up the last job of the day?
Yes, but I have to pull the mail train tonight. Can you help me with the mail tonight?
I'd be happy to, Percy, but Oliver wants me to help him find Duck.
What? He's still missing?
Take care, Percy. The night's not looking too good tonight. There's a big storm coming in.
Percy, where is my goods train?
I thought I left it in Napfer Yards last night.
Well, Percy, looks like we've got a mystery on our buffers.
Maybe try retracing your steps, Percy. If you look in all the locations where those trucks were, maybe you'll find clues as to where they are now.
Looks like our thief came back, and he seems to have been looking for something.
I don't think it was a he per se, but it was indeed searching for something.
Well, it was all very disorienting, but I think I saw a little tank engine. The engine had a large mouthpiece and goggles on its face, but I couldn't quite make it out.
I have to warn him somehow. Things aren't as they seem. I tried that pannier, but he was gone before I could say anything. Maybe, just maybe, he will listen.
And now the conclusion. The train, for its time, is the most powerful vehicle on land. And the engines of Sodor are the power behind the docks, industries, and branch lines that make up the Northwestern Railway. This is Toss and Friends with Railway Adventures. Within the week of Duck's return brought up many questions among the residents of Sodor. The most talked about ones were, who is this mystery engine? What does the engine want with us? Why did the engine kidnap Duck? All these questions swished around every engine's boiler and fuel tank. Everybody was worried, especially after Stephanie told about the massive mess at Vickerstown Goods Yards. They just didn't know what to do about it, and hoped it wouldn't happen again.
I can't believe that Sir Topham Hatt took me off of mail duty for a month just because Emily was dragging me all around the island. I had nothing to do with it. Why didn't he believe me? I mean, come on! I'm the victim here! What the? What is that? Hey! You there! What do you think you're doing? I just shunted those trucks less than 10 minutes ago. Alright. I think we got off on the wrong buffer here. Please stop puffing toward me like that!
Who are you? Do you know the number one?
Yes, I do know him. He's my best friend, and to answer your first question,
Good. Take me to him, please. There isn't much time.
What are you talking about? There's plenty of time. We have all the time in the world.
No, we don't. Trust me, I know that. As we speak, dark forces are closing in.
What do you mean by... What on Sodor?
There's nothing to be scared of. It's me, Lady. But I'm from the future. A century in the future. I have grave news to give to you, Engines. If you would please hear me out, I think Thomas would take this news the easiest way. So, would you mind?
No. If you have something to say, tell me first. Then, I will tell Thomas.
As you probably know, I, or at least younger me, is the keeper and guardian of the Goldust and the Magic Railroad. But 100 years from now, exactly a century from today, Diesel 10, but not as you might know him, destroys the Magic Railroad and causes the universe holding Sodor to disintegrate in the blink of an eye. So I have come back as a warning to tell Thomas that if he ever sees Diesel 10, to show no mercy and absolutely destroy him in order to save the future.
So what you're saying is that he needs to kill Diesel 10? I'm not going to say that. He'd think I'd gone mad. And you know how he is. He would never try to kill an engine, especially not on orders of his future girlfriend.
I do wish there was another way, but there isn't. It has to be done before time runs out.
What do you mean, before time runs out? We still have a century before it happens. A full 100 years. And what did you mean by not as you know him?
Here, if you don't believe me, see this. It was taken the night before he did that deed. May 30th, 2118.
Good Godred Almighty, this is terrifying. When does this happen?
It was June 21st, 2075. He was coming after Thomas and I, in one of those useless chases to try and destroy us. Then I blew my whistle and formed a massive lightning bolt to strike Diesel 10. That lightning bolt zapped him clear up to Kingdom Come. Afterwards, a big company named Cyberdyne Systems decided to fix him. And 5 weeks later, on July 26, 2075, at 12:15 p.m., he appears at Matford with a gigantic gun and blasts the entire town into rubble with one shot. Thousands died, many more injured, billions of pounds for the repairs. Soon afterwards, Sir Topham Hatt went bankrupt, and the entirety of the NWR was bought by the Manchester Steel Company, hence the logo on my bunker. They were able to repair the physical damage and give us these upgrades, but the screams of those who had died that day are always burned in my mind. Many of the survivors around the world called the event Judgment Day, and I've been chasing him ever since for years, trying to avenge those who were unfairly slaughtered. This is why I need to erase Diesel 10 from the timeline, so none of the terrible events would happen.
Oh no, he's coming! Quick, distract him! I have to make the jump back to my time! Don't tell him anything, and remember...
Little engines can do big things.
if they believe in themselves. Always remember that.
Hey, Percy. What's up?
Oh, nothing, Thomas. Nothing at all.
Later that day, after being told about the future, Percy was very worried.
If the future only holds death and destruction on that scale, we might only be able to look at the past for good memories. Probably a good thing that the 103rd anniversary of the MWR is coming up in a month. But if only there was a way to stop the future from coming. I wish you could help us, Lily. You were always the smart one, at least according to the others.
Shunting trucks and hauling freight, red and green and brown and blue. They're the really useful crew, all with different roles to play. Round Tidmouth sheds are far away, down the hills and round the bends, Thomas and his friends. Thomas sees the cheeky one, James is fame and lots of fun. Percy pulls the mail on time, Gordon thunders down the line. Emily really knows her stuff, Henry tits and hops and puffs. Edward wants to help and share, Toby, well let's say he's square. They're two, they're four, they're six, they're eight, shunting trucks and hauling freight, red and green and brown and blue. They're the really useful crew, all with different roles to play. Round Tidmouth sheds are far away, down the hills and round the bends, Thomas and his friends. Duck, the great western one, Molly is shy but get work's done. Justin pulls the heaviest load, Oliver with his brave van toad. Rosie, she's so kind and true, Donald and his twin deadlift too. Stanley puffing down the line, Lady, she really makes you shine. They're two, they're four, they're six, they're eight, shunting trucks and hauling freight, red and green and brown and blue. They're the really useful crew, all with different roles to play. Round Tidmouth sheds are far away, down the hill.